Imagine a man praying to God that he gets to marry you. That man is the man who God has for you. And that's what we're going to talk about today and discuss this idea that the man who God has for you will pursue you, as well as a couple other things I want to mention real quick. Now, before I get into this subject, I want to hear your comments on this, your thoughts. So please comment below and make sure you like the video and subscribe to my channel, of course. I got more videos coming, and I'm going to be providing you with the content that you have been asking for. Now, let's get into this. The man who God has for you will pursue you. Yes, he will pursue you, but that doesn't mean he's going to chase you. I see a lot of women of God, a lot of believers who get into this mindset that they can pretty much go hide in the corner and that God's going to drop this man in their lap and everything's going to work out because he's going to come after you and he's going to make it happen. And unfortunately, this way of thinking is a setup for disaster every single time. Because the reality is that, yes, the man who God has for you is going to see your value, is going to want something serious with you, is going to want to build with you, and he is going to be willing to put forth the effort to getting to know you and reaching that next level with you. However, if you take an approach that says he has to chase me, he has to earn my attention, he has to jump through all these extra hoops, you are very likely to either push him away or block the pathway of that man getting to you in the first place. Now, you may say, well, no, that can't happen because if that's who God has for me, then it will all work out. That's not true. Again, we have choices we have to make in life. And we have to understand that plenty of people, plenty of women, since I'm speaking directly to the women on this one, have set themselves up for failure, have pushed those men away, have sabotaged those situations, have been unable to properly receive, nurture, and experience the great relationship, and not just the great relationship, but the great life that God had laid out for you. So you have to be aware of not only how to be ready and willing, and I know you may say you're willing, but actually emotionally, mentally, and spiritually willing and ready to receive, nurture, embrace that man and that life and that purpose that God has laid out for you. And you also have to be able to know how to recognize it, because so many women get hurt, get caught up in dysfunctional relationships because their selection process is off. They are choosing the wrong man to entertain. They are allowing themselves to be occupied by dead-end relationships and men who have no interest in pouring into you the way God intended to. So let me give you something real quick. I have my book, The Man God Has For You. It is a best-selling book. You can check the reviews. Women are going crazy over there. They are loving it. It is setting them free from negative cycles, negative relationships. And it is helping them find that great relationship, not just with a man, but with themselves and with God. So I want you to check it out again, The Man God Has For You. And real quick, you can also click the link in the description, or you can click the link that I have in the comment section so that you can go straight to the page and get your copy right away. I'm telling you, this is worth it. But let me touch on something that I mentioned in the book, one of the chapters or one of the sections. And it piggybacks off of the statement I just made about women's selection process and getting involved with the wrong guy. So there's a section in the book that talks about the prayer that most women pray. And that prayer is, God, if this man is not for me, please remove him from my life. Or, and I'm paraphrasing because you may say it in a different way, but essentially, God, if this is not the guy, taking him away, make this easy for me. You know, eliminate this situation from my life. And in the book, I explain why this is not the way to pray. Let me give you one of the biggest reasons why this is not to pray. Because in a lot of situations, if not most or all, what you're essentially doing is, one, putting the responsibility on God and not yourself to make the right choices and to move in the right direction. That's not what God's trying to teach you. Like, if you have a child, think about it. Do you want to always do things for your child, or do you want to teach your child how they can do for themselves and move in the direction that you know is best for them? So guess what? God wants the same for you. So one, you have to always be willing to embrace your role and your responsibility to make the right choices through his guidance. But also the other issue with this prayer is you essentially go into this position of wait and see. And when you're waiting and seeing, you have your guard up. You have walls up. You are essentially not pouring into the situation and you're waiting for the next ball to drop that says, get out of this situation or he's not the guy for you. And that may sound okay to some of you, but if you haven't healed, if you've already been through some things, then you already are looking at things with a very skeptical eye. And therefore, you are going to jump at any little thing, even when it's not something you should be running away from, or even when it's something that could be easily addressed and corrected. So you put yourself in a very defensive position by praying in this way. So in the book, I give you the way that you should pray, the way that you should address this issue and talk to God about it so that you can make sure to know when you're dealing with the right one or the wrong one. And there's a bunch of other things in the book. It breaks down the 7 traits to look for to know if this is the person you can spend your life with and to know if this is the person that God truly has for you. So be sure, again, click the link in the stat in the description, click the link in the comments, and also leave your thoughts below. Yes, the man God has for you will pursue you, but he's not going to chase you. And you got to make sure you are ready and able to receive him so that you can experience the love that God has set forth for you.